62-year-old mastermind behind RuPaul's Drag Race opened the doors to the Beverly Hills mansion that he shares with husband Georges LeBar, and it's even more fabulous than you could ever imagine. Yes, I'm talking about RuPaul. While the 10,309 square foot home initially had 6 bedrooms and 5.5 bathrooms. Really? You need 5.5 bathrooms? Wow. Fru enlisted the fabulous handiwork of the interior designer Martyn Lawrence Bullard and architect Christopher Hatch McLean to reconfigure the European-style residence. The house features a very bold black and white kitchen, a disco room with 26 hanging disco balls, a dining pavilion, not a dining room, it's a dining pavilion, inspired by Elizabeth Taylor, an orange office lined with all of Rue's Emmy Awards, a yoga meditation sanctuary, that's right up your alley, Jay, and the requisite outdoor space with a gorgeous pool and spa that can be quickly retrofitted into a stage for impromptu performances by any visiting Drag Race queens. Watch this.
Hello, AD. I'm RuPaul, and welcome to our crib. Now this is our disco room. We love music, we love to dance. And you know, when I was coming up, there was always a place where that said cocktails, dancing. Doesn't happen anymore. So we decided we need a disco in our house. And
you see this, Al? You've probably seen the house yourself.
Disco balls up there. And at the end down there is Hollywood Regency, Dorothy Draper inspired fireplace. That is one of my favorite things. And of course,
everybody.
I have many of my favorite disco artists. Some who are not so disco, but they're all beautiful and inspire us to dance. And move around. This table here can be moved at any time. It's on wheels. So the idea is to have people over for a little nosh and then move the table out of the way and then have a daytime disco right in this very room. I love, love, love this room. It may be my favorite, but don't hold me to that. Now this is our kitchen. Again, it's very bold. This is a stove that is made by a French company called La Cognou. And orange is my favorite color. You're gonna see a lot of orange in this house. I love these lighting fixtures right here because they remind me of those underwater scuba gear from the 1930s and 40s, but they're just beautiful. I love, love, love the finish on these cabinets and black and white. You'll see a lot of that in the house too. The floors are painted and stained in black and white, and it just makes me happy. And if you can't be happy in your own home, how the hell are you gonna be happy anywhere else? Lock on you!
RuPaul lives like a true queen in his opulent castle. What are we all talking about? Did you see my mouth like on the floor like for most of that video?
That was me the first time I watched. I was like, what you would envision RuPaul lived in literally is exactly what RuPaul lives in. 10,309 square feet.
Wow. You know, I could fit my house in there about 10,000 times.
Not 10,000.
Okay, I know.
A few times.
But it sure feels like that, honey.
Mine is 3 times.
Wow.
Woo.
5.5 bathrooms. Like, I wonder if you say this week I'm going to wipe my ass on this bathroom.
But who lives with RuPaul? Ain't got no children.
No, it's just him and his boo.
Him and his boo ain't got no children.
No, that's 4 ass cheeks.
So they could
for RuPaul, 5.5 bathrooms.
You can adopt me, okay?
And me.
I can stay in one of them rooms, boo. We can have a disco every day, okay? I have no problem.
Shiny disco balls.
Yes. Not at all.
And you see the Donna Summer on the.
I love. And did you see the Donna Summer documentary on HBO Max?
No.
Oh my God, I watched it last night.
I have to
see
it. Oh.
Oh God, it's so good.
I love Donna Summer.
I love, love, love Donna Summer.
What is Donna Summer? Diana Ross, like,
yes.
All those like old school,
yeah.
Right? That they still get on stages today, and you're like blown away by this, like their vibrancy and just like their.
I love that homage to
disco.
All of the disco divas on the wall, and
I want to see his closet.
Those. Did you see those? there's a flash of his closet. Oh my God. You haven't seen the whole thing.
No, his closet's the size of my house.
It's crazy. It's insane.
But, you know, very cool of Architecture Digest, right?
Yes, Target,
right?
Architectural Digest.
They always go to these incredible homes and do this, you know? Yeah. So about time that they went to RuPaul's house, because obviously it was deserving. Wow.
I know, that had to be a massive project.
Wow.
Can you understand the sheer... How much money he probably put into that?
Ooh. Well, that fool's got a lot of money. Do you remember MTV Cribs?
Yeah.
Why say like that?
Because after I found out that some of them rented like a home and...
What? Why are you spoiling it for me, Jay?
Are you serious? I'm sorry. Yes, some of them. So Mariah Carey showed her authentic house. I can't remember the ones. But
other people rented a
home? They would rent a house and then they would
throw some pictures in there.
Exactly. And stage it as if that was their house. I only enjoyed the authentic people, like Method Man show his real house, which he lived in the hood.
And Red Man came
in
over to roll a blunt and everything, right?
And he was like, this is where I keep my stereo. Like, keep it real. Keep it 100. Keep it real.
Well, congratulations on all your success.
Yes, I mean, congratulations, RuPaul. That was just...
Your house is incredible. Yeah. You should do tours. Maybe when you die, it could be like Graceland.
No, just invite me to live there.
Okay, just invite you to live there.
Yeah, just me.
So, did you enjoy the show? I know you did. So make sure to click subscribe so you won't miss any of the events, news, or interviews right here on the Faye What Show. Ring the bell at the bottom of the screen, right there, so you'll be alerted every time we're live. You can also click on the Happening Out Television Network logo so you can see all of the shows on the most diverse LGBTQ+ media network. Find out just what we're doing to bring the L and the G together right here on the Faye What Show. Get the week started with me,